Mr. Bergeron's on. Don't forget the popcorn, Frank.
Coming, dear.
So when is it time to move to a memory unit? Okay, you're in the independent assisted model. You've got some extra help. Still doing okay. When is it time to move into the memory loss? And I think that, you know, that line in the sand is a little bit different in each assisted living and for families to decide when it's time to make the move. But I will tell you that if somebody's in the independent assisted living, they really show a lot of memory loss. They're not getting the socialization, the activities. Sometimes people tend to shy away from somebody with a lot of memory loss, and they're not fitting into the dining room as much as they used to. It's not a good situation for your relative to be in. So it's better to put them in a setting where they can talk with people who are very similar with their disease process. If they start to need a lot more hands-on help throughout the day and even into the evening, they're waking up at night or they need help going to the toilet, the memory loss has the staffing capabilities to bring someone to the toilet without only being within those, you know, designated times or the time that you have extra help in the apartment. When they're not managing well anymore, items are getting lost, more repetition in their questions, getting confused and lost within the facility that they once were able to navigate. So asking the same questions over and over. You'll see as the memory loss progresses, you'll also hear from the staff as well. And the input from the staff is very important. They're really looking for the best interest of the client who's here. And again, the lastly is assistance with walking, transfers, and help with standing and sitting. You know, that's unlimited in the AVITA unit here. But again, as people age in place for various reasons, all of a sudden more help is needed. You can bring in the visiting nurses. You can get some physical therapy to help on a regular basis to come in and to do some strengthening exercises. And that's a good thing to do always. But then there comes a time that even with the exercises, it's just not enough. And remember, the memory unit does have activities geared for the senior with memory loss. And so they just fit in a little bit better. Can my relative stay at the assisted living the rest of their life? That's what we always want. We don't want to keep, nobody wants to keep moving. They get settled and then they get moved again and they get settled. Everybody wants to stay in the same place. It becomes familiar, it becomes their home, it becomes their family. And that's the goal here, and it's the goal at many of the other assisted livings, is really to age in place. And so the time to move, you try to bring in more services if you can. You also can bring in hospice so that people are allowed to live here through the end of their life. When it becomes a medical situation, as Linda said, where certain meds are needed, where it needs to be a medical oversight, this is a social setting, not a medical setting. And that's the difference. You can bring in all the services to allow someone to age in place and to be able to be here with hospice. And I think that is an important question with the assisted living. You know, when do they, how do they see their model? When is it time to move out? What do they see? How do they see seniors living here? And they don't want people to leave, trust me. They get invested. They have a relationship not only with the senior, but they also have a relationship with the family. And that's very important. And they don't want their clients to leave, but there are times that it's really in the senior's best interest.
Hello everyone, I'm Jazz Civitan. I work here at Carriage House at Lee's Farm. My title is the AVITA Director. So AVITA is our memory care and dementia neighborhood. And I say neighborhood for a specific reason. Let's go to the right here, okay. I say neighborhood because that's what it is. Neighborhood, what does neighborhood mean to you guys? If you hear neighborhood instead of say unit or facility, what does that mean? Anyone?
Family
Exactly.
And you're sharing back and forth. It's not just alone time.
Exactly. So gone are the days that we say unit or facility. We say neighborhoods, and because that's what it is. It's the Avida neighborhood. So, next slide. So for instance, let's take the Avida Memory Care neighborhood. This picture is actually our activities room. If you notice the contrast in the colors, it's welcoming, it's warm. We want our residents to come to our neighborhood and feel like they can succeed. This is going to be a success for them. Because unfortunately, the residents that we're getting on our neighborhood, they have Alzheimer's. They have a type of dementia where, you know, their day-to-day life isn't as easy as your day and my day. They need staff. They need us to make the connections for them to create success. So you'll see a lot of our slides that I show you, little bits and pieces of what our neighborhood can offer and what our neighborhood is about. So on to the next slide. This is our creative activity room. Notice the colors. Notice the artwork that's displayed. It's our way of creating a space for our residents that they can succeed. It's a program where you can have an art program and get your hands dirty and really show your creativity, because that doesn't go away with this disease. If you were once creative in your earlier years, or maybe you majored in art, that doesn't go away. That love is still there. So what we're here to do is not only provide that for residents that it is important for, but that's also, that's home. That's what you would do at home. Create beautiful pieces of artwork. This is our dining room created for success. And why I say created for success. So here are our tables here, and you can't really see the table settings, but I'll explain them to you. So our table settings, instead of having the fork, the knife, the spoon, a mug, a glass, we're going to have the simple utensils that are necessary for that meal at that specific point. So say if you have your soup, you're only going to have that soup spoon there. Why? Because if our residents are dining and they have the options of, say, the soup spoon, the teaspoon, the fork, they might not know which one at that point to decide to use, and they'll get frustrated. And so our job, being the Avida director and working with our aides and working with our activity staff and working with our families that come in, we're going to just put the soup spoon out because it makes that connection for the resident. They didn't struggle. Okay, here's the spoon. Oops. Here's the spoon. They've made that connection, and we, behind the scenes, made that connection for them, but the resident doesn't know that. They made it for themselves. We are setting up those connections for our residents for success. Also, the color contrast. Again, it's a little hard to see here, but instead of a white tablecloth, say a white placemat with white napkins, with our folks with dementia or Alzheimer's, they're going to look at that and they're not going to see that contrast. They need the colors to pop. They need the colors to be different so they can have a successful dining experience. And you might think that I'm talking a lot about dining, but dining is so important. Unfortunately, with this disease process, as it progresses, our residents are going to forget that they're hungry. They're going to forget that they're thirsty. And so what's important for our staff is to create a dining experience that is successful, because we need our residents healthy. We need our residents to understand and be part of the dining experience and have successful dining, which is a program. When you hear activities and when you hear programs, you might think an art program or an exercise program. Well, those are all programs, and they're all very successful, and all of our residents need those. But dining is a program, and washing dishes, that's a program. What do you guys do at your home? Those are all programs. I know when I go home, I do the laundry, I take my dog out. Those are programs. So yes, we provide the exercise and the programs that are fun. We have accordion players come in and entertainment. But you have to think of the smaller programs, doing the laundry, washing the dishes, folding clothes. Those are all programs too, and that's what we can provide here. This is just a picture of our private dining room. And in fact, the pieces of artwork were actually illustrated by our residents at a paint bar, which was fun. So the private dining room has many different concepts. You can have a program there, maybe a bingo program, if you will, an art program, you can host exercise if you move the tables out of the way, but private dining room is also important because with this disease process, our residents are going to forget how to eat, what to exactly use. Do I use the fork? Do I use the spoon? And how do I take that fork and bring it to my mouth? So what we do is we meal model. So we'll sit with our resident in conversation and have just like home, and we'll eat with our residents. If our resident sees myself, say, dining, they're going to take what I'm doing as a cue, and they're going to have a successful dining experience. So this private dining room has many different ways that we can finagle a program, but it's very important to have. It's a little bit quieter, takes away the distractions, and it's very important to us and to our residents here. Our beautiful kitchen, and it says memory making baking. That's very important. That's one of our big programs through the whole entire company, memory making baking. So everyone has a recipe that you probably always made when you were younger, maybe with your mother. I know mine was an Oreo mousse, I made with my grandmother. But what you're going to do is you're going to make, say, those chocolate chip cookies that are delicious. You're going to have the ingredients out on the counter so our residents can chomp on the ingredients as they're making the cookies. But what else am I going to do? I'm also going to have the cookies in the oven so they can smell the cookies. We need to stimulate the senses. Our residents need to smell those delicious chocolate chip cookies. It brings them back to a time maybe they're making them with their mother or maybe with their dad or their sibling. And it brings back those memories, those good memories. And this is their home now. This is where they live. So why not bring those wonderful memories back to them and now a place that they can call home?